हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल हिंदी सीबीएसई क्लासरूम। प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल एंड हिट द बेल बटन नेक्स्ट टू इट सो दैट यू विल गेट नोटिफिकेशन व्हेनेवर आई पोस्ट अ न्यू वीडियो। आई हैव क्रिएटेड सेपरेट प्लेलिस्ट इन माय चैनल फॉर ईच एंड एवरी क्लास, सो प्लीज़ चेक द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स बिलो एंड सेलेक्ट अकॉर्डिंगली। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज टॉपिक। टुडेज टॉपिक इज क्लास 7 चैप्टर 1, हम पंछी उन्मुक्त गगन के। पंछी मीन्स बर्ड, उन्मुक्त मीन्स फ्री, गगन स्काई, सो वी आर द बर्ड्स ऑफ फ्री स्काई। सो दिस इज अ पोएम वेयर द पोएट एक्सप्लेन्स द फीलिंग ऑफ बर्ड्स हु आर केज्ड। दे फील वेरी ट्रैप्ड इनसाइड अ केज, दे वॉन्ट टू फ्लाई हाई एंड टच द स्काई, but they are unable to do so because they have been caged by the humans. So the poet is describing their feeling, how they feel when they are inside a cage. So let's see the first para. Hum panchi unmukt gagan ke, pinjar band na ga payenge, kanak teeliyon se takrakar पुलकित पंख टूट जाएंगे। सो हम पंछी उन्मुक्त गगन के, दैट इज वी आर द बर्ड्स ऑफ फ्री स्काई। पंछी बर्ड, उन्मुक्त फ्री, गगन आसमान, आसमान मीन्स स्काई। पिंजर बंद ना गा पाएंगे, पिंजर बंद मीन्स केज्ड, वी कैन नॉट सिंग, ना गा पाएंगे मीन्स वी कैन नॉट सिंग इफ वी आर केज्ड। In a cage, birds cannot sing because they are feeling trapped. And we are the birds of free sky. So how can we sing in a small trapped cage? Kanak teeliyon se takrakar. Kanak means golden colored. Teeliya means the cages will have rods all around, right? So, se takrakar. Takrakar means hitting. By hitting on the golden rods of the cage, पुलकित पंख टूट जाएंगे। पुलकित मीन्स समथिंग दैट इज फिल्ड विथ जॉय और फिल्ड विथ हैप्पीनेस। पंख मीन्स विंग्स, टूट जाएंगे, दे'ल टीयर अपार्ट। सो द बर्ड्स आर सेइंग बाय हिटिंग ऑन द गोल्डन रॉड्स ऑफ द केज आवर विंग्स दैट आर फिल्ड विथ जॉय विल टीयर अपार्ट। सो this para is the birds are telling we are the birds of free sky, we cannot sing in a cage and because our wings we cannot fully spread our wings because our wings are touching or are hitting the rods of the cage. And what will happen if the wings are continuously hitting on the cage? Our joy filled विंग्स विल टीयर अपार्ट। हम बहता जल पीने वाले मर जाएंगे भूखे प्यासे, कहीं भली है कुटुक निबोरी कनक कटोरी की मैदा से। सो हियर द पोएट इज सेइंग, हियर द बर्ड्स आर सेइंग हम बहता जल पीने वाले, वी ड्रिंक द फ्लोइंग वाटर। बहता जल मीन्स फ्रॉम द रिवर्स, फ्रॉम द वाटरफॉल। वी ड्रिंक, वी आर द बर्ड्स, वी शुड ड्रिंक फ्रॉम अ फ्लोइंग वाटर, नॉट फ्रॉम द पॉट और द बाउल यू कीप वाटर फॉर अस। दिस इज़ नॉट आवर टाइप। आवर टाइप इज़ वी शुड बी एबल टू ड्रिंक फ्रेश वाटर दैट इज़ फ्लोइंग इन द नेचर। बहता मीन्स फ्लोइंग, जल वाटर, पीने वाले मीन्स वी आर ड्रिंकर्स। सो वी ड्रिंक द फ्लोइंग वाटर। मर जाएंगे भूखे प्यासे, वी विल डाई आउट ऑफ हंगर और थर्स्ट। मर जाएंगे मीन्स वी विल डाई भूखे प्यासे। भूखे प्यासे मीन्स भूखे मीन्स हंगर बिकॉज आउट ऑफ हंगर, एंड प्यासे मीन्स आउट ऑफ थर्स्ट। वी कैन इवन डाई ऑफ हंगर और थर्स्ट, बट कहीं भली है कटुक निभोरी। It is way better. What is way better? Katuk nibori. Katuk means bitter. Bitter and nibori is neem fruit. that yellow fruit we see on the neem tree, right? So the birds are saying it is way better, katuk nibori, that is the bitter neem fruit is way better than kanak katori ki maida se. Kanak means we already discussed, that is golden. Katori, golden colored. Katori means bowl. Ki maida se. Maida se means the people who cage the birds, they serve the grains. Maida means maida flour, or we make chapati, roti or parotta and something, and we give it to birds to eat. So they are saying what you serve, what you people serve in a golden bowl is not good for us. For us, the bitter neem fruit is much better than the things or the food you serve in a golden bowl. So in this paragraph, the birds are saying hum behta jal peene wale, we are the people who drink directly from the flowing water. Mar jayenge bhooke pyaase, we will die of hunger or thirst. Kahin bhali hai katuk nibori, it is way better, that is neem fruit, bitter neem fruit is way better than the food you serve in golden plated bowl. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Swarna shrankhala ke bandhan mein apni gati udan sab bhule, bas sapno mein dekh rahe hain taru ki fugni par ke jhule. So swarna shrankhala means chain, swarna means golden, ke bandhan mein, because you have given us golden chain in our neck, that's why we have forgotten our speed and flying power. That is swarna shankala means golden chain, ke bandhan mein means because you have captured us in a golden chain. Apni gati udan sab bhule, apni gati means our speed, gati means speed, udan means flying or flight. Sab bhule, we have forgotten how we used to fly, what is our speed, because you have captured us in a golden chain. That is we put golden chain around bird's neck. For that they are saying you have trapped us in the golden chain, and because of that we have forgotten our speed and our flying capacity. Bas sapno mein dekh rahe hain, sapna means dream, we see only in our dreams. Taru ki fugni par ke jhule, taru means tree, ki fugni means the tall branches of the trees. Par ke jhule, jhule means swing, the swings in the tall branches of the trees. So the birds, you would have seen the birds sitting on the tall branches of the trees, and when the wind whooshes, the branches will swing with the wind, and what happens, they feel like they are sitting in a swing. So they are saying only we can see in our dreams that we are sitting on the tree branches and swinging with the wind. Swarna shrankhala ke bandhan mein, because of the golden chains in our neck. Apni gati udan sab bhule, we have forgotten our speed and flying ability. Bas sapno mein dekh rahe hain, we can only see in our dreams. Taru ki fugni par ke jhule, the swings in the taru ki fugni par ke jhule, the swings that are in the tall branches of the trees. Aise the arman ki udte, neele nabh ki seema paane, laal kiran si chonch khol, chugte tarak anar ke daane. Aise the arman ke udte, arman means our desires, we had desires that नीले नभ की सीमा पाने. We had desires that we could fly and we would fly till the end of the blue sky. नीले नभ means blue sky. सीमा पाने means we can touch the border of the blue sky. ऐसे थे अरमान की उड़ते. अरमान means desire. We had the desire that we would fly till the end of the blue sky. We'll fly till the end of the blue sky. लाल किरण सी चोंच खोल. लाल किरण means red sun. The birds are comparing their beak with the sun. So our beak, we will open our beak like the sun, like red color. Their beak is red color, so they are comparing their beak with the sun. So red colored beak, they will open their red color beak. Chugte tarak anar ke dane. Chugte means pick. Tarak anar means they are saying how the tarak means stars. Anar means pomegranate. So they are telling they will pick stars like looking pomegranate seeds. Okay, because as we see pomegranate from far, as we see stars from far, they will be very small, like that even they feel the pomegranate seeds like stars. So what they are describing the pomegranate seeds as stars. So they'll open their red colored beak and they will pick pomegranate seeds which are looking like stars. Aise the arman ki udte. We had desires that neele nabh ki seema paane. We had desires that we could fly till the end of the blue sky. लाल किरण सी चोंच खोल चुगते तारक अनार के दाने. वी विल ओपन आवर सन कलर्ड बीक एंड विल पिक स्टार्स एंड विल पिक पोमग्रेनेट दैट लुक लाइक स्टार्स. सो नेक्स्ट पैरा. होती सीमाहीन क्षितिज से इन पंखों की होड़ा होड़ी. या तो क्षितिज मिलन बन जाता या तंती सांसों की डोरी. सो हियर द पोएट इज सेइंग होती सीमाहीन क्षितिज से. क्षितिज मीन्स इट इज अ पॉइंट वेयर स्काई एंड अर्थ मीट. Even in when we see, we can see a point in a very far away, that where our eyes can see that there's a point where earth and sky meet. So that point is called kshitij. So hoti seemahin kshitij se in pankhon ki hoda hodi. Seemahin means borderless. Hoda hodi means fight. Okay. So they are telling होती सीमाहीन क्षितिज से इन पंखों की होड़ा होड़ी. So our wings will fight with the borderless, boundaryless point where earth and sky meet. होड़ा होड़ी means fight. So our wings will fight with the with whom it will fight? It will fight with the borderless point where the earth and sky meets. या तो क्षितिज मिलन बन जाता. क्षितिज मिलन means there is a chance that we will see the point where the sky and earth meet. या तंती सांसों की डोरी. Or else what will happen? We will die. सांसों की डोरी means तंती सांसों की डोरी means our breath will stop. That is the birds will die. Either what will happen? Either we will find the point where sky and earth meets, or else we will die because they are fighting with each other. Either the borderless The borderless point where the earth and sky meets will win, or else we will win. How the birds will win? The birds will win if they find the point where the sky and earth meets. Okay? So hope I made it clear. Hoti seema heen chitit se in pankho ki hoda hodi. Our wings will fight with the borderless point where earth and sky meet. Ya to shitij milan ban jata ya tanti saanso ki dori. Either we will see the point where the sky and earth meet, or we will die because they would become exhausted, because they have to fly very far, far away to see that point. So they'll get exhausted and they'll die. नीड न दो चाहे टहनी का आश्रय छिन्न भिन्न कर डालो, लेकिन पंख दिए हैं तो आकुल उड़ान में विघ्न न डालो. सो वॉट दे आर टेलिंग, नीड न दो. नीड न दो मीन्स डोंट गिव अस अवर नेस्ट. नेस्ट इज नीड मीन्स नेस्ट. द बर्ड्स मेक नेस्ट. चाहे टहनी का, टहनी मीन्स ब्रांचेस. डोंट गिव अस अवर नेस्ट मेड ऑफ ब्रांचेस. आश्रय छिन्न भिन्न कर डालो. आश्रय मीन्स अवर शेल्टर. यू कैन ब्रेक और डिस्ट्रॉय अवर शेल्टर. लेकिन पंख दिए हैं तो, बट इफ गॉड हैज़ गिवन अस विंग्स, आकुल उड़ान में विघ्न न डालो. डोंट डिस्टर्ब अवर फ्री और रेस्टलेस फ्लाइट. So here birds are saying, you don't give us a place to build our nest made of branches. You don't give us a place where we can have a nest with the branches. Or you can, even if we have already made our nest in any of your place or any of your trees, you can even destroy it. छिन्न भिन्न कर दो means you can even destroy it. But if God has given us wings, you don't have any right, or you should not disturb आकुल उड़ान. आकुल means very eager or restless. We are very eager to fly. That, so don't disturb our eager, the flight that is full of restless or eager. We are very eager to fly. So don't disturb our akul flight, that is our restless or free flight. So that's all about the poem. So this poem is written by Shiv Mangal Singh Suman. So let's just summarize it. So in the first paragraph, the birds are saying, we are the birds of free sky. We cannot sing in a cage. Our wings will, by hitting our wings on the rods of the cage, our wings that are filled with joy will break. We are the birds who like to drink from flowing water. We would die out of hunger or thirst. That doesn't matter to us. But the food that you give us in golden plated bowls are not good for us. The food that we find from the nature, that is the bitter neem fruit, is much better than the food that you provide us inside a cage in a golden bowl. Then the next one, Swarna Shrankhala Ke Bandhan Mein, and because you have trapped us in a golden chain around our neck, because of that we have forgotten our speed, our flying ability. But only we see in our dreams how we can sit on a tall branch and swing in it. ऐसे थे अरमान की उड़ते. वी हैड दीज मैनी डिज़ायर्स दैट वी विल टच द एंड ऑफ द ब्लू स्काई. we'll open our red sun-colored beak and we will pick the pomegranate seeds that look like stars. Next one, we will fight with the borderless or endless point where the sky and earth meet. Either we will find the point where they meet, or because we are exhausted to fly these far away, we will die. Need nado. Don't give us nests that are made of branches. You can even destroy the nest we have already made. But if God has given us wings to fly, please don't disturb our restless flight. Okay, so I hope I made the poem clear. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and do let me know in the comment section below what chapter, what class you need me to do on the next class. So that's all. Thank you.